Hey, it's just me this time. Yeah.
That's a little dirty.
Ah, that just made it worse.
Cool.
If you drink, I'm going to kick you. I told you guys not even to be in my room right now.
Because I'm making Mandalorian armor.
And I need to be in my zone.
Oh, shut up.
Why don't we turn on the Mandalorian theme?
Yeah, sounds
get into
like...
it.
Would you like some stuff in your camera?
Okay. Alright, the starting of Mandalorian armor. Cutting templates. So I'm doing the helmet first. Because helmets are awesome and we love helmets and yeah.
Helmet's pretty.
Also, I'm pretty sure I could take any piece of armor and pretty much just stick it with it and it would look pretty good. Tell him if he doesn't stop, he's getting kicked out.
Literally kicked. Okay,
okay.
Let's get the chair off
me.
Then I'll stop.
You can
get out. Okay, I'll get out and then I'll stop.
Hey, one person's watching. That's awesome.
Annoying little brother, so. That's what we have to do. I like watching. You can still hear that part of Disney in it. That is Disney?
Yeah, dude, that's the whole point of it. How do you think they make the world know that it's theirs?
Iconic music. So that's a good template run. Okay.
Who's leaving?
Shut up.
Okay, gotta get the bottom for that. That's good. Need that for later because that's a little intricate detail piece. What the hell's that one for? Have to look again. Seriously, guys, get out. You're being annoying, both of you. I don't care. You're both being annoying.
I'm having him leave you alone.
You're both annoying.
Mm-hmm.
check. Sure. Hey, we got two on. What's up, guys? Okay, so that's the first template set cut. Then these are, they're all left pieces, so what I have to do is I have to flip them, make a right piece. Oh, hell, do I have Sharpies? I hope I do, because if I don't, I am not,
I'll help you start with him.
And this will not be Jango Fett or Boba Fett. This will be built. So it's my own, but it's modeled after the Mandalorian from the Mandalorian series.
If you haven't watched it, Disney Plus.
So it's pretty badass. Hopefully it all looks come together well. I am using a new method, which is tab markers. So tab markers allow me to line everything up a little bit better. Okay, put it down. I don't want a big one. I need a... Go away, go away, go away, go away. How many times do I have to tell you to go away? Also, chat. Come on, guys, chat. I want to know what you guys are saying. So I got a mixture of... 3 millimeter, or 10 millimeter, and... half inch. It's basically the same size. The 10 millimeter is a little bit smaller, so it should, that for those more intricate details where I have to like bend it, just gives it that little bit. Also, I should be wearing my glasses. Okay, stop handing me shit. Are you fucking kidding me right now? You want to get punched in the face?
I'm giving you.
You're throwing it into my workspace. Stay out of my workspace. Oh, wow. I forgot how much I am actually blind.
You really can't see that well.
I actually can see really well. I have 20/24 vision. Or 20/22. But...
I think I have 15/10 vision. I have better
vision than
normal, so.
What?
I, no, 2020
is the best.
I have better than normal vision myself.
Whatever, kid. Just go. So nobody's going to use chat? Okay.
Don't you have to be like, don't you have to pay to use chat or something?
No.
Oh,
really? Never. Oh, this is gonna be so cool.
Hudson has like 33 missions too. He lost his glasses.
How?
He can't find them.
What do you mean he can't find them?
He just can't. He's like, okay, that's just cool.
Whatever. Just be quiet. Making Mandalorian armor. So this is going to be the cheek piece, which is awesome. God, I can't wait for this to come out. I want you guys out, seriously, because you're distracting to my work. You're distracting to it. It is a lot of mental focus and self-searching. What? Switch up the music. We're gonna do something else because I need some, like, you know what? We're gonna play the Star Wars playlist that I have. There's my Star Wars shirt. We're getting it. We're doing this house shit. There we go. Lila, out. Out. She will jump up on the work table. You don't think I'm... You think I'm kidding?
She thinks
I'm kidding. Gotta get in the Star Wars zone. I don't have a chair because I'm a bitch. Thank you. wish I had a beveling table. That'd be so nice. $600. Plus, I need a good computer to run software. It can run CAD. Doesn't mean it can run Slicer and Onshape. Oh yeah, I need to go see if my blade's sharp. That's an okay cut.
Call you or a minion.
What are you doing, child?
That was very stressing. Why don't you just leave it out there for a minute again? So. Okay.
I'll tell you, little assholes, what. You gotta promise me you don't fuck up. Both you out.
Yes, sir.
Alexa, volume 6.
One second. Oh, God.
Fuck this up. Okay. There we go. Let me grab my mini chair. This is a good song. Anakin versus Obi-Wan Kenobi. Yeah. You can totally hear the Harry Potter in this part. It is amazing. Like, anytime this song pops on at this moment, I honestly God think it is Harry Potter each and every time. Because it has that exact same flighty kind of mood to it. same strings, I believe, too. What do you mean you can't find it? What's up, Pat? Okay, somebody keeps popping on and popping off. Like, they're like... They sound like me on Tuesdays. Kidding. Shut up, you little poops. So, yeah, it's just a lot of cut, place, cut, place, draw lines, cut, glue, sand... But you guys will get to see, like, I mean, I've been doing this for 3 years now, so 3 years of this, or no, Anakin is now on the dark side. Okay. So, 3 years of this, and... Yeah, no, it's been three... Holy shit, it's been 3 years of this. Where's my ABUs? Because those have... One of the sleeves has my pen in it. There it is. Okay, so... I cut out... This is just the helmet pieces... Basically, what I do is I take my foam, and I'm basically going to start tracing them on here. So let me move my camera over here. That way you guys can see the printing process.
Yay.
Wow.
Also, the foam isn't unbent yet, so it makes it a little bit more complicated. Nothing I can't handle, though. Foam rolls are a lot more cheap. They're way cheaper. You can get them in specified thicknesses. And what else is good about it? They're just cheaper. You can get them in a little bit different colors. They're also a little bit more malleable. So I have to do all these pieces. So, and what do you mean by how much? Like, how much did it cost? Is this pen gonna work? So, I have to do all of the lefts, and then I have to do all the rights. And to, okay, so for just the foam, I believe this run that I'm doing right now was... I want to say it was $17 for a 13 by 52 slab. So that's decent compared to, because if you do, you can do $20 for the sheets, but those aren't as malleable. They also have the texture on the back, where this one is the same texture on both sides, so you can use both ways. So like, say if I only made left sides on accident, I could just flip over the one and it'd already be a right side, which is really nice to have. Very cost effective. So, yeah. A lot of people say use Sharpies, use pens. It really doesn't matter as long as you're getting your lines nice and on there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make two of each piece. And then... One will be right, and then I'll flip it over, and on the other side, I'll write left.
And also they have these little, so they have these little lines on them, which those are called marker lines, which actually is a new technique I'm using, which it's supposed to help line up pieces better. And it should be interesting to learn how to work that. So, but yeah, it's amazing how like my ODST suit, it was probably $80 just to make the base suit. That was the base suit. Then you throw in the fucking, the lights, the extra foam, the fucking paint, the decals, the redos, all of that. It makes it that much more expensive. Like, there's probably a $300 suit just in that. In man hours, I could sell the thing for, you know, a good 1,800, whatever. So, hey, two people are on. What's up? So, yeah. So, yeah, my own Mandalorian armor. Okay, have fun. Be gone. This is F, this is A, C, could be a little bit lower, oh god, B. B. And then you basically just, usually what people do is they flip them. I'm too much of a bitch, and I bought special foam belt. You go in your inventory. It's not that hard.
What do you flip them on?
I don't know! Off the top of my head. Okay. So that's this piece. Ah, poop. Okay, so this is my L. So then I'll know that this one is my... Hello, Civil War. Who are you in terms of humans that I know? Who are you? Do I know whom you are? Or you're an elusive person that I have not met yet? Can I, would it be okay to flip these guys? Nope, can't flip them. What if I do it this way? Can I flip you? Maybe. You, I'm questionable. I mean, if I really smush it up there, maybe. But we'll just reset you over here. Because I don't want to accidentally waste foam. Because that shit's expensive. Okay, this is another left. And then I'm going to put a number up here. So this is number one, and then this will be number one. That way I just know. Gotta be smart about this stuff. Okay, so this will be number two. Sorry if my Star Wars music is way too loud. Well, hello, Mike. I don't believe I know you. But we shall see. But yeah, with the spite of the new Mandalorian TV series coming out, I was oh so down to make my own. I mean, I have the ODST, so might as well go Star Wars. Then after this, I should probably make Destiny, but Destiny has so many intricate things, and it's kind of a pain. Thank you.
Yeah, my nose is itchy. But yeah, I got off of work and I came here, or came home rather, and like all my phone was here, and I was just like a kid in a candy store. I was like, yes! Yes! I do actually sell it. I haven't really sold anything yet. I also do guns. So here, let me just show you one of the gun props because you're asking now. This is an Ace of Spades, straight out of Destiny. So for a 3D printed model, just non-built, it's about $60 to $80 depending on what size you want it, and then for a fully painted one, they're usually $114 online, but I can always cut deals because I'm new. But yeah, it's like, and it's got the twisting barrel assembly, so, but yeah, it's pretty badass. I cannot tell you how many times I've been up like till 12 o'clock building this shit. It's great. It is the best feeling. You're sitting there and you wake up and you're like, oh god, it's, I fell asleep doing the job, and there's like a big streak across because, you know, your marker just, you're like, oh no. I can't tell you how many times I've cut my bed or accidentally painted my bed too, because I work in my room. Probably not the smartest idea, but I don't give a fuck. So, yeah, there's your answer. I do sell it. So, and I did get access to a 3D printing area, so I can do a lot more intricate models, but they're smaller 3D printers. So, like, I would just 3D print a helmet, but I can't. So, like, I can do pieces, I can do little accessories, what have we. And I'm truly sorry if my music in the background is, like, blasting. I'm not, dude, you think I'm living the dream, but seriously, like, it is such a convoluted mess, and I have gotten into fights with people. Like, I went to Comic-Con this year, and I didn't, so I built my, a base model ODST, and I went and changed it up to my own aspect and everything, and a guy actually wanted to fight me. He was like, that's not right, that's not, I'll fucking kill you. And also, my parents hate it, like, they hate it when I come home with materials. They're like, wasting your money again, huh? Which they don't realize, like, a suit is $800 out the door with no paint on it. That's fucking expensive. I haven't sold one yet, but that's how much you can go for, because I haven't built a second one, so I couldn't sell it. But that's how much people are willing to pay for these. And I know, I got fucking friends in Australia that are like, yeah, man, I sold 6 of these this week. You know, I'm up, and they're all fully painted, and I'm making, you know, $6,000 a week just for making suits. And it's ridiculous. I'm sitting here going, I want some money. But it's that part of, you've got to find people that want to buy it. And that's the hard part, because I live in the middle of Prescott. That's too big. Mm-mm. Yeah, I'm gonna have to do this one. Oh, I could. Oh, could I? I could try to sneak you in. Sneak him in, sneak him in. Oh, yeah, we're gonna sneak you in here. We're sneaking it in! Okay, I feel you with loud music in the car. If I had actual speakers in my car that weren't broken, I'd be blasting that shit too. And I mean, Alexa, volume 10? I mean, I would, you know, wait, hold up, she's... Go away. But copyright.
What's the next one?
Hell yeah, we're gonna get in the zone.
Also, if you guys want, just try to spread the word, try to get some more followers on here, because if things go well enough, I might make another set and possibly do a giveaway on it, or I'll teach you guys how to make it, because I know this isn't really a tutorial, it's kind of just like a, watch me build, I'm cool. But I would be totally okay with doing a tutorial on it, that way you guys can make your own, and I'll put full links to everything. I was thinking about doing that, maybe do a giveaway of a helmet or some piece. I got some extra guns in there. And then, what else was I going to do? I don't know. But spread the word. Help me out. But yeah, so. And then, I don't know. I got a lot of stuff I want to do, and having people that want to watch really does help. And I do have a question for you guys. So, I'm not a naturalist, and I know I'm going to get backlash for this. But, I love different, changing it up a bit. So, I can do the classic black visor that everybody loves. And, you know, it's really menacing and all, but I have three other colors. I have red, orange, and purple. I was wondering if I should do one of those. I feel like a red one would be pretty sick. Because I am my own Mandalorian. I am actually basing this off of my own character, and I am writing a book on it with my brother. I don't know if that's something that people would want, a different visor color, but I think it's pretty badass. You know, like a red visor, just the red cross. It'd be terrifying. Like, that's, for me, because I'm also probably going to go back to, like, a traditional red and black armor set. That's just what I've always done. I always think that's a cool armor set, or red and white. And red is always menacing, and I feel like if that's on their face, you're going to be like, no, I'm good. I mean, I might just be crazy. Pretty sure I am. Okay, so this will be my left one. This is J, J, J. And this is a 40-degree bevel. Try purple and black. Okay, so what will happen is when I build it, so you'll have like this. It'll be kind of sprung out, so I'll have to close it using some tape, and then I can slide it in, and you guys can see the different variations, but I figured I'd ask now. I don't have a black one. I mean, I could just go spray paint one of those really quickly with a light coating, or maybe it'll be like a grayish. Oh, you know. I could try that. What I might do is, if worse comes to worse, and like I can't get a full black one, I could take the red, quick draws over it, which would be like, it wouldn't completely color it, it'd still be see-through, but it'd have the red in the back but the black on the front, so it'd really be like a deep red. Who knows, could be cool. So this is what I got right now. I don't know how well you guys can see, but those are the templates that I got as of right now. Got a number, everything. Don't be afraid to wasted a little bit of ink on it. It does not hurt. If you do that, I will tell Pat to buy it. Are you talking about the black and red? I can go wild. I mean, you guys, I'm trying to make my own character right now, so going wild is what you really got to do. You got to be like, what's going to work here? Meh. God, I sound like Ryan Scott all of a sudden. Black and purple? I'll try it up. Purple for royalty, maybe.
who'd be a higher class. But my brother and I were writing our own book right now, and we're supposed to be – so in the Jedi books or whatever, in the holocrons, there's only been one case of a Force-sensitive Mandalorian. And so we were like, fuck the books. We're doing it ourselves. So this is post-Order 66, like beginning of the Rebellion. So, like, what would that be? That'd be negative 10 ABY after the Battle of Yavin. But we'd be two brothers that are both Force-sensitive Mandalorians, have our own master, end up going to the Cave of Ilum, getting our own kyber crystals, and actually indulge you guys. So Michael and I are, my brother, we're fucking, oh my god, we are the biggest nerds on Star Wars. And so he and I went and dropped 900. Keep that in mind. I'm gonna type it in chat. $900 on lightsabers. And so this is my personal one. And it's yellow, because Jedi Temple, right? We have every color. We are nerds. Nerds. So if there's anybody out there that's like, I'm a bigger Star Wars fan. Yeah, so three different lightsabers, a Temple Guard, a Peace and Justice, Power and Control, and then a Order and Control. So they all have different weights in different areas because they're full steel. Like these things, we beat the crap out of each other with. Like we actually beat the crap out of each other with, and like flourish and everything, and go in and have some video actually on my nice camera. But my camera's being dumb. But these things, like, we practice all night sometimes because we hang out a lot. And it is some of the most fun I've had in a while with him. And you can throw in a different kyber crystal. Right now, I just have the yellow one in there. He has all of them at his house because I left them there. But we have purple, white, yellow, green, blue, red. Unfortunately, and that's like all you can buy. I really wish they had the orange and the light blue, the cyan, because those ones do look really pretty. But each kyber crystal was $20 itself. Each lightsaber was $300, or just under $300. So, like, and then each blade, so there's doing class blades, different sizes, lengths, all that, jizzity jazz. Those are like $30-$40 each. So it's, dude, it was a fucking haul. And they're all custom made to what our liking. So there was like a bunch of different pieces you could pick from. Then you'd go through and be like, oh, I like this piece more than this one. And then you'd choose it, and, you know, you got that. And you're like, oh, you're pretty cool. So, it was a haul. But well worth it in the end, I would say so, for some pretty badass lightsabers. So, yeah. So, we originally had a Star Wars book, but we kind of scrapped it because we started watching The Mandalorian, and then, yeah, all that happened. And we're like, okay, we want to be Mandalorians now. And go ahead with your question. Shoot. Cortana reference. Shoot. I will answer all your questions, boy. Come to me with your questions, yes? I don't think I'm gonna get two helmets out of this. That pisses me off. I'm gonna have to buy more. No! Not my fault. Well, I could do it that way. Let's do a mark there. Let's just do this. Do people give me crap for what I do? every day of my life. And honestly, I couldn't give a shit because I enjoy it. I love it. And I have a really big passion for it. Now, yes, you do get that praise of, oh my God, you literally, here, let me, look. I'm going to indulge you a little bit more because you haven't seen all the stuff I've done. Yeah, let's open up the closet of wonders. We'll just pick out something pretty basic. So, like, this was a 2-day build. Took me 2 days. Full class magnetic mount, Halo SMG, Mark II ODST from Halo 3, suppressed. So this thing, 2-day build, red and gray paint, I think is actual real Picatinny rail. And I got some crap for it. They're like, oh my God, you made a gun. You're going to kill people. Oh my God. And then there's those people, the suppressor's too big. Extremists. And you're like, okay, I don't give a crap. I like it how it looks. I mean, whatever. But then you get those people that are like, dude, you build that in 2 days? That's fucking crazy. You're awesome. And so, like, it's a balance of people that are like, you're gross. You're weird. And you do get a lot of, like, you're weird. Because you got to get into it. You got to understand what you're building. You got to go into the dynamics of everything that you're doing. And you got to know the story inside and out. Because you can't just be like, I built it. Okay, what is it? Where did it come from? Who did this? Who used this? Whose gun is this? Is this something new? Like, you usually come up with a full character design behind one gun. And so there's a lot that you have to do with that. And people are like, you're crazy. And then there's just people that are like, bro, I want to be you. I will. Like, I went out. I'll come back. Let me put this away. Ow, I just cut my finger open. Fun. You also give yourself a lot of crap because you do cut yourself in the process. Like, not like, no, you're sitting there with one of these cutting through foam and you got to have it on your lap and shit or your finger slips in. And you're like, motherfucker, you're stupid as fuck. And you piss yourself off. And then there's also, like, I went out to an airsoft match. It was a middle sim, a year back almost. And I whipped on the ODST suit because we're playing like a Fallen game, like a Apocalypse. And I got this guy, we nicknamed him Redbeard because he had a red beard, and obvious, but we're sitting there and we're like, he's like, dude, can you teach me how to make it? And like, I'm 16, this guy's like 22 years old. And he's like, dude, teach me how to make it. I want to know, like, you can come over, we can smoke some weed. I don't fucking care. Teach me how to make an ODST suit. And I was like, sick. We ended up falling out of contact and I never was able to teach him, but like, you know, like, there's that shock and awe for people, and then there's those people that are like, you're weird. So there's both sides to it. Wow. All right. Back to building. And honestly, I like it when people give me crap for it because sometimes it's crap for criticism, and you learn from that. You're like, okay, I shouldn't have done that. I should have done this differently on it. Like, constructive criticism. But then there are those assholes, and you're like, I will fucking rip your cock off in your sleep. Try me. But being a part of this community, you also have a lot of people that will rise up for you and help you. I know that personally. Like, I went out to a Comic-Con event. I had all my gear on, my ODST, and I ended up actually getting heat stroke during it. I passed out. And some people were like, oh, he's acting. He's cool. You know, he's got a suit of armor. He's cool. Every Halo guy that was there at this event ran over because they knew that I got a heat stroke because that happened at these events. A lot of guys, they wear foam and it's so closed and it doesn't breathe. A lot of people run cold jets through them or they'll run fans. I didn't have money for that. And they knew that because they could see the different quality of my suit, the different materials I used. It was a lot cheaper stuff. And every single one of them ran over and was like, bro, rip my helmet off.
Hi, dog. Hey, baby.
It was pretty cool, you know, seeing that there's that camaraderie of hey, we know that this guy's in trouble. We need to help him. So, it's a brotherhood. You got to understand that there's faults in everything. That's what it is.
All right, next question.
I'm such an idiot. Okay, this is F here. D. Okay, so this will be my L. Oh, my music turned off. That's why it's so weird. Oh, yeah. Well, let's listen to some Def Leppard. So, any other questions? Like, anything you want to know? I am going to do these guys on bigger foam because they're supposed to, it's supposed to be like this one goes out further than that one.
Let's just say drama happened at school. People are douchebags, and it happened. You can infer from that if you know what drama. Lots of drama.
Dude, don't worry about it. So that's why I'm not saying exactly what happened, but drama happened. That's what's going on. So.
Bye. Burning up inside me.
So is chat just being slow? Like, is it coming in slow? Are you guys having trouble with that? Because it could be my end that's messing that up. I don't know, though. I'm live. There's that. There's my left. I'll show you guys how many pieces I got here after I finish up this little guy right here. That way you guys can see. Yeah, go right ahead. Just don't be dumb. There's all that. Oh, snap, crackle, and pop. So I got this many done now. So that's a pretty good haul for 50 minutes and having to cut still. That's amazing. Cutting actually, it does usually take a little bit longer than most people expect, but I've been getting a lot better at it. And Matt, if you want to, if you do want to buy one of these, I would be more than happy to sell you one. We can talk offline, and I will be more than happy to get you a helmet. And right now, I will only have the helmet because that's my main objective, because I'm going to go watch the next Mandalorian episode with a freaking helmet on and be like, I'm cool. Oh, that's me. Ooh. We're on what? Piece five? Five. So, if you do really want one that bad, I would be more than happy to hook you up. Okay, I think this is a one piece. I could do this. Through your soul, you can have it all. Frick it, let's whip on some Japanese music, man. And the schoolwork and the armor, dude. Okay. The armor part, that's for fun. That's my de-stressing zone. My little brothers, I deal with them on a daily basis. That's okay. I've done it since I was six. And then schoolwork, I'm an A student, so this hasn't hampered my progress at all. Also, another reason why I'm doing The Mandalorian instead of, like, Boba Fett or Jango is because The Mandalorian himself, he does have a smaller helmet, which I have a bigger head, and Boba Fett's is just so big. Like, if you look at the comparisons, there's a very big difference in size, and I do want a smaller helmet just because I will probably end up using this in an airsoft tournament just for shits and giggles, especially around Halloween time. That's what we usually do. We whip on some crazy-ass costumes, and we go fucking have fun. And I want to look more stealthy. Also, the Mandalorian is just sexy. He is hot. Hot. I may be a guy, and I know I'm not supposed to, I say I'm not gay, but dude, I'd be gay for a Mandalorian. The shit you say sometimes. You really question yourself. Especially when you hear the legends of a Mandalorian, you're like, mm-hmm. So. What?
How do I sign into the movie?
I'm about to show you guys in a second. You guys have to go down to look for custom game.
Okay.
And then go into local. Okay. I feel the work is a pain in the ass, bro. Ugh. I can't do it. And they're like cutting me off. Like I went in today and had to sit in the lobby for 3 hours and didn't even get paid for showing up to work, for actually working. Because they didn't want me on the clock because they weren't making enough money to actually keep me on. So I didn't even get paid for my work today. But little did they know, I clocked in anyway. Because fuck that. If I'm going to show up, I'm going to fucking clock in. You're not going to not pay me for being at work. That's a little... Like, that's wrong. Isn't it? That's illegal, right?
I think it is.
I'm probably wrong. I'm weird. Oh, is that my... Wait. Let me get this right one. Oh, God. I'll just use a new one. I got paid enough. And then college ROTC, what branch, bro? Better be Marine Corps or Navy. And I work at Dairy Queen. Ooh. Ooh. Hey, I got a treat for you. First off, 6 generations of Marines inside my blood. And United States Marine Corps, Aura. Oh, yeah, this is a much better murder. Yeah, man, 8 miles a day. Just so that way I can get through boot camp with flying colors. Nasty. I mean, I'm not gonna fault at the end of the day, you know, we all bleed the same colors. You know, that's how it goes. You give each other crap, but like, you know, it's still the service, it's still something. And dude, as many times I want to say the Air Force just sits on their ass all day, my dad, they saved his ass multiple times, so I can't give them that much crap. I will give them crap, but not that much. Hell, my colonel roasts me more than I can even imagine. And he's an Air Force boy. Also, if anybody can tell me what song's playing in the background, if you can hear it, I will congratulate you on being an amazing person. Or at least what the song is from. Okay, this is piece number 6. Okay, I have this little midget right here, and then I got a few more. Holy crap. Dude, that's a lot of foam, though, for this. Like, it's usually, never mind. But like, I'm not used to, this is just a helmet. Although now that I think about it, I mean, no, that's a lot. This is a pretty small piece of foam. So should have bought 2, but I didn't have the money in the bank because work keeps cutting me off. God damn it. Yeah, that's How to Train Your Dragon, man. I'm a fucking nerd. Dude, I'm a fucking nerd. Yeah. You guessed it! Alright, next time. This one, seriously, if you guys can't guess this one, you don't know life. If you cannot guess this, you do not know what life is. I wanna be the very best. Like a
God, I love music. First songs I watched with my brother. Screamo version of Blue Da Boo Dee Da Boo Die. He does.
All right.
Daddy,
okay, I'm on my way.
He's coming.
Had to go snatch up my insurance information. Forgot that came in today. Music is life. Music is love. And how have I made your day, my good sir? In what ways? Doom? Yeah, we're gonna have fun. So also this channel that you're on right now, this is my brother and I, so we do stuff together, but I just was like, oh yeah, I'm going to go do stuff right now. I'm a bitch. God, I smell like ants. I don't try it now. Yeah, that'd probably be the most conservative mode of doing it. I do, but I have no videos on it. I literally made it last night. So this would be mine, but, you know, kind of not. And then also, if you look on this channel, there are some drawing videos, which those are also my drawings that I've done. But, you know, because my mom and dad don't really want me to have my own, so my brother owns it, and I just do it with him. But I do have a Twitch, which my Twitch is... It's a little loud, and my mom is sleeping for work tonight. So,
need to let her sleep, unless I would like to be shot in the head with a gun.
Just kidding, that actually wouldn't happen, but damn near. Yeah, I just don't have any software to record anymore because of my parents finding out about my old one and getting all mad at me, so. Yeah. And I also have an Instagram, which is the same thing, except the A's are in there. Because It should be. It's just like the actual spelling of Eagle Biohazard, not all funky like that, because my gamer tag had to come out funky because somebody stole it. How dare they? Douchebags.
Ooh, this kid's got a cool. We're going to steal it.
Motherfuckers. Asshole.
Little shitbag. Okay, hopefully that's still all lined up. But knowing me, it's probably not. But I don't give a rat's ass.
Now, I did find this technique of putting down templates, which I thought was so crazy that this guy did it. He basically glued them all on and then spray painted over them and then peeled them off in the backdrop. Was the template, the negative space. And it was like, I was like, oh, that's really cool. But you also have to do a lot of, you have to use a different material instead of paper, and I'm cheap.
So I was like, nah, I'm good. I'll stick with my paper method.
Just have Doom casually playing in the background. We are 4 parts away from being able to glue and, or cut. Cut comes first.
Then we glue.
All right, see you, man. All right. This is piece number 8. Hey, Pat, you're back. Look at you, you magical being.
Oh my God.
Please don't question me. I know I'm weird already. Just let me be me. Yeah. Dude, that's so weird. He got off and you got on.
Patience.
I'm fucking with you guys.
I am fucking with you.
2 more! Woo!
Oh, wait, no, not 2 more. There, 4 more.
4.
Don't worry. What did I say? Question me, please. Just do it naturally. Naturally question Colin.
All right. I don't know. I'm weird. Please.
Lift me. Oh, there's hair on my phone. Imagine that for a thumbnail. That'd be a great thumbnail. Don't you agree, Patience? Okay. Holy crap. Holy crap. I am this close.
This is some great music.
I hate myself. The fumes are starting to get to my head. Whew.
Oh my ball.
So this is F H. I'm not saying you're insane. You bump me right now, dog, I swear I will have to punt you. Just kidding, I love my dog so much. Oh, I love her so much. Okay, so this is right side. Okay, H, F, K. Oh, nice. Fucking man. Guess what time it is. Cutting time. I'm not ready. I'm not, but
we're doing it.
Alright, you guys ready to watch?
Can you cut my hands off? It is a precise, skilled operation that requires the most skill. It requires patience. It requires focus to detail. And then you're letting Colin do it. That doesn't work. Okay. That is our first left side piece. Fucking awesome, guys. Pretty clean cut, little bit of a variation slide in there, but nothing a Dremel can't fix. So, but yeah, that is right here. That's actually literally the placement that that's going to have. It's going to be bent. I don't have a heat gun, so I'm going to take a blowtorch to it. So it should. Oh, I can't fucking wait. All right, first piece done. Only 9,990 more.
Oh yeah, I should probably label this left.
Did it.
Thank you. eyelids are nice and clean. I really like this film. It cuts so nice.
How's it going?
What? I've cut one piece. Yeah.
It's crazy. Okay. Well, let me go back to one more person.
There we go. So supposedly, this guy is supposed to be beveled. And these guys sit ever so nicely together. This is awesome. All right, so what I think I'm going to do is, this has been an hour and 30-minute stream. I'm going to end it so that way I can go cut all these out, and I will go do some stuff on gluing, and you guys can see all that, all right?